Happy Halloween, fellow bush babies, and welcome back to another episode of Minecraft, where behind me, you can see the fruits of my livestream endeavor. Here is our potion shop. Look how cool this looks. And as you can see, the whole world has been remade Halloween. We're going to come on in here, take a look around. This is where our shop attendant is going to sit. Here's where all of our potions will be stocked. I've already gone ahead and placed down signs, so our attendant can go ahead and fill them out whenever she likes. And we have plenty of room to expand back here. We're gonna have all of the negative potions stocked back here. And I believe over here, yes, over here, these will be where splash potions can be made. These will always be full, or at least have some gunpowder in it. So, we want to go straight away over to the board to go ahead and get rid of that sign, because we've already built the potion shop. And we need to decide who it is that's going to run this place, because, well, we don't have any villagers kind of on hand looking for a job, and we definitely don't want to uproot everybody. So, I see a awesome cow over there. Hello, cow. Hey, there's another sign up here. All right, let's just break this first. Built the potion shop. All right, let's see. I have an idea for who can run the potion shop. Andrew. Okay, well, he's a pretty smart guy. I would have imagined he'd have some idea. So let's go on over there and see them. Oh, I wonder if the villagers have dressed up for Halloween. I guess we'll get to see now, won't we? Ooh, spooky. Hey, he dressed up as a cyclops. Hey there, Andrew. How are you doing? All right, let's see what you've got to say. There's a name tag in here. All right, let's see what you've got to say. Ah, the familiar feel of a teacher's desk. Back at my village, I was quite the professor and inventor. It's good to see the inside of an academic building once again. Thank you, Bush Baby. The minds of both young and old villagers are safe in my capable hands, so to speak, of course. I'm sure you're wondering where I sleep. I don't. Teachers don't sleep, silly Bush Baby. Teacher, you need to go back to school. If there's ever anything you wish to learn about, feel free to come here, no charge for lessons, so long as you accept the responsibility of obtaining research samples for me, of course. Ah, you came about the sign. Well, who usually brews potions? Witches, of course. Using a name tag, you can capture one and put her to work. I've provided a tag for you, so good luck. Well, that sounds like a very dangerous endeavor, Andrew. Are you sure about this? Are you sure? I don't know about this, but you know what? Okay, we're gonna go ahead and try this. So I guess we have to give the witch a name. And that would make sense, because in old folklore, if you named something, it meant that you bound it and, you know, held power over it. So I guess what we're going to do is we're going to go name this real quick. And we need to figure out a way to actually capture a witch. Now, that doesn't sound like it's going to be too easy of a task. And, hey there, buddy. Well, look at you. Aren't you all dressed up? Come and turn around. There you go. Hey, buddy. All right, now there doesn't seem to be any charge for naming name tags, so you know what? I'm just going to take that as they are free. And what name should we give a witch? Grimhilda. I'd say that's a perfect witchy name to me. Now let's get that out of hand. And we need to figure out what we're going to do and how this is going to work. And we need to do it fast because the sun is setting. So I think it would actually benefit us if we made a few potions. We already have some awkward potion bases in here. So why don't we make... Why don't we go ahead and make a couple of healing potions? That's the splash potion of weakness. We've got melon slices. Alright, let's see here. And where is the crafting table. Crafty crafting table, in fact. It's sitting right there. And we need to go home and we need to dump these potatoes, because that is not what we need to eat during the Halloween episode. So let's throw that in there. And we'll throw that in there. And you know what? We'll throw the sign in there too, just because we don't need it. And while those are brewing up, we should be able to come on by and pick those up afterwards. We need to get a few things. Now, I don't know how to trap a witch, to be completely fair. Witches are a lot smarter than zombie villagers. I don't think we're just going to get them to wander on into a trap. So, I'm gonna go get set up, and I will meet you guys back here, and I think I should have an idea by the time we come back. Okay, so I thought to myself, what can we do to trap a witch to get her in a minecart? Well, put down a minecart. I thought about all kinds of different things that we could do, and I thought maybe we could try to modify the other plan to just sort of put a pressure plate out here and then doors snap around her. And then I thought, well, why don't we just put her in a hole? But you know what? I think the best plans are the simplest. So, what we're gonna do is we're going to try and lure a witch back through here, and this is gonna be a problem because there's holes everywhere. But I think we can do this. Now, that there. And we need to work fast because it is coming towards nightfall. And we'll put that there, and that should be about enough. Now, hopefully, we should be able to do this. We will lay tracks down like this. Oh. And we'll try to lure a witch over. And when she gets near enough, we just bump the mine cart against her. Let's come on in here, and I want to try and get a couple other potions. We're not going to take them all. We're also not going to take all of the pumpkin pie. Because if we die, we don't want to have to, go and round all of that up again. Water bottle. We need three of those. And it's turning towards night, so we need to make this fast. What I want to do is I would like to brew up a few night vision potions too. And it is already turning towards night, so we want to immediately name this witch before we do anything else because we don't want to die with a name tag on us. That would be terrible. We just need one of these. What extended time? I do believe it was redstone. We want this to last as long as possible. So, before anything, let's just go out and see what we can find. I know it's a bit dark, but we're gonna fix that here soon. Let's see. Have we already found a witch? Is that a witch? Oh, that's a skeleton. That is a creeper. No, thank you, creeper. Oh, things are already getting spoopy. There we are. All right, now let's go back and get that potion, because I'm sure it's got to be ready by now. All right. Oh, now look at that. That is much better. That is beautiful. Look at that bright night sky. Well, sort of. Now, we only have 8 minutes of night vision, and we need to find ourselves a witch. There we are. And of course, we have ourselves a healing potion just in case the worst should come about. I'm looking and I don't see any witches. Considering the holiday and everything, you would think there would be quite a few. Maybe they're just being shy. Oh dear. Did I just say, oh dear? Oh, bother. There we go. I feel like this is going to be our zombie villager hunt just all over again. All right, let's eat ourselves another piece of pie. I see an Enderman up there, which we will not be bothering with. Okay, so for anybody who missed it, my husband actually joined me on a live stream yesterday. Yesterday as of recording this. And that should be up by the time this episode is out. Holy crap, that looked a lot different than it should have. But we had ourselves a little bit of a challenge, and it was more of a let's fail than a let's play, which was fine because we had a lot of fun. But I think I want to involve him in a few other things because it was just so much fun. What is that up there? Oh, is that a pig? Okay, never mind. I don't like any of you. I need witches, buddy. But anyway, it was a lot of fun, and I hope that you guys enjoy the video if you have seen it. If you hadn't, well, the biggest thing of note was somewhere near the end when we were getting completely owned by an entirely invisible skeleton. So, that's something to watch it for. Well, look what we have here. I believe those are witches. Now, things get a little bit scary because there are two witches and a skeleton, or no, two witches and a spider. So what we're going to try and do is just peg this one. Get her to come over here, maybe. No? Come on. Come here, you can see me. Alright, she's coming over here. Oh. Oh no. Oh dear. Okay, we have to do something risky. All right. There we go, okay. That was not good, but it was not bad either. All right. First thing we need to do is go up here and get some more gear. Now, unfortunately, that witch might wander a little bit. But we do have a whole chest full of gear. Another diamond helmet, irons, and we're looking specifically for irons, which I know I've got. Iron leggings and... what is this? This boots, boots, boots. Iron boots. All right. All right, now let's see if we can't go find Grimhilda real quick. We could sleep, which might be the better option, but... You know what? Let's just go up here real quick, get us some swords. And we need some food, but we do have some still at the potion shop. I'm gonna need a few of you dogs. I'm sorry, buddies, we may lose a few of you in the process. Oh, wait, 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 that might be a bad idea. They'll attack the witch. Okay. Now we died near... where did we die? Ah. Okay, we died over here. Okay, now we need to heal, and we also need to find Grimhilda. We'll throw you in there, and we need another night vision potion. Wow, you took a lot of beating. All right there, Alex. Sorry for the disturbance. All right, so Grimhilda was around here somewhere. At least I think she was. Or at least she was in the general vicinity. And that means now we have a named mob just sort of roaming around wild. And we don't know where she is. So this could be a little bit problematic. In all hopes that Creeper did not kill her. Because there was apparently a Creeper explosion over here. And I believe she was following us. Oh. Nope. I believe that would be her. Yep. All right. She was behind. All right, guys. We have the witch basically right outside the door. Or at least she should be about now. Yep, there she is. We have Grimhilda basically right outside our door, and we need to figure out how to get her into a mine cart. So, I think. Okay, I've gotten a bunch of wood. Let's make a couple of chests. Or at least a chest, and dump everything, literally everything. We do not want to have to lose a bunch of stuff. And we go out there, we try to get her into the mine cart. At least then, if we fail, we aren't losing much of anything. All right, I don't mind losing a few swords. There she is. And now we get out of dodge. All right. We have Grimhilda in a minecart. I never thought that I'd have to say that before in my life, but yes, we have Grimhilda in a minecart, and she's probably gonna kill us if we get too close. But we now have her contained. Let's go and get some more food, maybe get ourselves healed up, and then we can figure out what we're going to do with her now. So, what I think we can do, and I've already got some steak just to get my health and my hunger back up. There we go. What I think we can try and do is pretty much just. Let's see what happens if we try to get in the door real quick and maybe get an invisibility potion. Whew, there we go. All right, now I can get my food. food, pumpkin pies. There we are. Now let's try and brew up. We've already got some of these in here. I believe for invisibility, it was just a fermented spider eye. I'm pretty sure we've got some of those, right? There it is. Alright. Let's see here. It's nasty and rainy and just blech outside. While that's brewing up, we need to accommodate things a little bit. Alright. Here, 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 and there. And then we just run some track up to there. No, get in the house. Alright. Now, I don't necessarily know how well this is going to work, but you know what? It's not going to hurt to try. Potion of invisibility. No, a potion of invincibility is kind of what we need right now. Let's try and go home, see if it's time to sleep. I'm hoping that it is, so we can clear this nasty rain up. And we will try and get Grimhilda into her shop and finish this episode up, because I think that's about as much excitement as any bush baby can stand. It looks like it's about time for bed. And that rain is very creepy. I didn't notice that was purple. Alright, let's get into the bedroom. A good night's sleep for a bush baby that has done so much. Alright, now let's see what happens if we do this. We have nothing on, nothing in hand. In all hopes, this should work. But then again, she might notice something's up when she is being pushed into a shop, so... yeah, we might not get away with this. Oh, she already notices us. That's not good. Oh, she noticed us immediately. All right. This is probably going to be much more difficult than I thought at first, but you know what? I don't even mind. Oh, crap. Ah, come on. No. Alright, I got my pie. Holy crap! Well, I don't know how that happened, but you know what? I'm extremely happy about it. Let's come on in here and get all of the rest of our stuff. I think that's about it. Yes, I know you see me, but I'm hoping that you can't actually hit me. We need this. I know you don't like me yet, Grimhilda, but we're here hoping that you like me eventually. That down. We need to get you out of the mine cart. Come on now. Oopsie. Oh, goodness, that was bad. That was bad. Well, Grimhilda, you're going to be working here for a while, whether you like it or not. So, we are probably going to give her a little bit of time to cool off because she looks mad. And I think we're just going to get these tracks up and we are going to leave her alone for now. Let's throw the pressure plate here. We put the. Nope, the door was already there. Door and stair, and we are ready to shop here. You gonna hurt me? You can't hurt me, thankfully. But you can if I get up there, which could be a problem. But you know what? That's a problem for another day. So, I think this has literally been one of the most stressful episodes I've ever done, but it was stressful in that fun kind of good way. So we're going to eat a celebratory pumpkin pie, and I'm going to bid you guys farewell. I'm going to get these tracks up, and by next episode, this potion shop is going to be all up and ready to go. So thank you very much for joining me, and I hope you enjoyed this spooktacular episode. I want to wish you all a happy Halloween and a safe Halloween. Please be sure to, follow all of your state's trick-or-treating recommendations if you go out for trick-or-treating and all of that. Just make sure that you stay safe. If you happen to be a parent, make sure that your kids stay safe. And that's about it. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and if you did, please leave a like. If you want to see more by me, then feel free to subscribe. I would always love to see new faces in the Bush Baby Army, I suppose. And we're gonna let that witch just kind of simmer back there because she looks a little bit angry still. But by next episode, I'm sure she'll have calmed down. It looks, in fact, like she's already healing herself. So, thank you again for joining me, and remember, Bush Baby loves you!